Hi, I'm Adina Kuncz, a food systems specialist at USAID. Join me for a tour of a USAID partnership that helps small and medium-sized dairy farms increase the volume and quality of the milk they produce, while also reducing their production costs. Today I'll be visiting the Colanta facility and two local family farms that Colanta and USAID are working with in Colombia. I'm starting the day with a quick team meeting before a 1.5 hour drive from Medellin to San Pedro, a small town north of Medellin where the Colanta factory is located. Today's team includes Colanta representatives, USAID Colombia colleagues, and Anjali Richards, a monitoring and evaluation specialist at USAID who works with USAID's mission in Colombia. My first stop is the Colanta facility, where Colanta representatives share how they support local farmers. They provide training, technical assistance, and machinery to support dairy and swine production. Our team also learns about the technology that is used to help farmers apply fertilizer more efficiently and access alternative fertilizer sources, which allows them to reduce their production costs. Once I arrive at the first farm, I meet with the farm owner, Blanca Patino, and her family to learn how the USAID partnership has helped transform some of their practices and improve the quality of their pasture land. Look at these pigs! USAID helps farms like this one use swine manure as a cost-effective alternative to chemical fertilizer. Identifying affordable fertilizer sources is critical for many farmers right now due to recent global-wide fertilizer supply and access issues. The partnership provides farms with machinery that processes the swine manure into fertilizer and applies it to the farm's pastures through irrigation. Without this machinery, it would typically take several people and a lot of time to create and apply the fertilizer to several acres of land. The partnership has also developed a mobile app that uses satellite imagery to help farmers determine which areas of their pastures need more or less fertilizer, ultimately improving their farm's productivity. These are climate smart agriculture practices, which is a great added benefit. After a busy morning, I am ready for lunch. We visit a restaurant that uses meat and dairy ingredients that are produced by Colanta and local partner farms. I enjoy grilled beef while my colleague Jose tries a burger. And of course I save room for dessert. This ice cream cone is so delicious. Before heading to the next farm, Anjali and I stop at the store next door to check out the Colanta dairy products available. I am especially excited to see non-refrigerated milk options. The Feed the Future initiative promotes similar products because it allows people without access to refrigeration to safely consume nutritious foods. The milk also has a longer shelf life, which helps reduce potential food loss and waste. The final stop is a dairy farm run by Andres, a local farmer. This farm produces 130 liters of milk per day. Here I learn more about how the USAID partnership provides assistance to small dairy producers to ensure that their milk meets quality and food safety standards to be sold to Colanta. The support includes providing cold storage containers for milk, safe pickup and transportation of milk from farms to Colanta facilities, sanitary machinery and milking practices, milk testing, and procedures for disposing of milk that is spoiled or contaminated. These practices help ensure that milk is produced as a safe and nutritious food source and reduces contamination risks that may otherwise result in large food production losses. The main goal of this specific partnership is to reduce participating farms' expenses and increase their production yields. But we hope that by increasing the volume and quality of local milk production, it enhances access to safe, affordable, and nutritious foods as well. I am thankful to our USAID Colombia colleagues, Colanta partner, and participating farm families for spending their day with me. It was great to see our Colanta partnership in action, and I look forward to sharing what I've learned with my team in Washington, D.C.